We have here a brand new 14-inch MacBook Pro with an M1 Pro chipset inside it. But how well does Office 365 or Microsoft Office work on this MacBook Pro? Well, today, let's find out. Hi guys, it's Matt here. So that's right, I've got here a 14-inch MacBook Pro and inside it's got an M1 Pro chipset inside it. It's the 10-core variety. So this has got the two efficiency cores, 8 performance cores, 16-core GPU, and also 16 gigabytes of RAM inside this machine. So today I'm going to be demoing kind of Microsoft Office or Microsoft Office 365 on this machine. We're going to be testing out the likes of, say, Word, PowerPoint, Excel, even things like OneNote and Microsoft Edge and OneDrive. And after this, I'm also going to be demoing some of the kind of Apple equivalent of Microsoft Office, and this is going to be like Pages and Numbers and Keynote on this machine, and see how well it performs. Well, let's get started, and first of all, let's go over to my kind of main screen recording on this MacBook Pro to give you a better view. So I'm just going to quickly show you here quickly what Mac I'm on. So I'm on a MacBook Pro 14-inch and it's got the Apple M1 Pro inside it. And this is the standard M1 Pro chipset, the 10-core CPU and the 16-core GPU inside, and there's 16 gigabytes of RAM. So let's get started then with Word first of all. So I'm just going to open this up. Now it'll take a little bit longer because it's the first time it's ever opening up. So it always takes a little bit longer, but there we go. So here I am in Word, and let's just say I want to open up this template here. Let's say this quick CV one here, so it's pretty cool. And I've just actually noticed something as well. I was going to get rid of that LinkedIn thing. The actual notch here, I don't know, actually, my mouse is going behind the notch, but you bet I could probably see my mouse there. That's quite clever, actually. So the notch, when you put your mouse behind it, actually still records it as a full screen. You can't actually see the notch here. But anyway, enough of that. So as you can see here, it's very, very Microsofty and very traditionally in this sort of template. As you can see, we can flick around on the different sort of things. I had no problems loading any of these ribbon items whatsoever, but we can change any of this. So let's say skills. Explain what you're specifically good at. I am good with Max. Let's just say that, for example. So you can see we can do that if I can actually spell Max correctly. We can actually like change the font here. If I go back to the home, we can make it a bit larger. Let's actually change it to a different style. Let's just say we're going to have it as Roboto there. I'm going to have it a bit larger. And I'm also going to have it, say, underlined as well. So you can see it's really, really snappy. It's really, really quick and good. This is fantastic, Word is. And like I said, you can fiddle around with all the different options at the top. There's no problems there whatsoever on this M1 Pro. So while that's open there, I'm going to actually open up Excel next of all. I'm going to keep this Word open. I'm going to open up as many as I can just to show you guys that it's really, really capable of it. So Excel's taking a little longer there, but let's say I'm going to do a totals list. We've got items here. Let's think of some items. Let's invent something here. Let's call something the iBoat. There we go. That's what Tim Cook's going to talk about next year. And he's going to also talk about the iCar. A lot of us have been wanting to see about that. And also the iPlane. Let's say we got them as well. They're pretty cheap as well. Let's say I want to make the iBoat about, let's say, $7,000. It's only a little rowing boat. And the car, let's make that, let's say it's $10,000 there. So yeah, that's a nice cheap car. And the plane, a little bit more, let's say $50,000, you know, or $500,000. That's more like it, isn't it, for a plane? But you can see the totals are working absolutely fine. We've got the different sort of layouts and things. We can change the theme if we wanted to. So let's say I wanted to do the sort of depth one. There we go, it's applied straight away. Change my colors around. I can do anything I want. I can even put a background in if I want to. Do the formulas, data review. You get the idea. The ribbon again is super quick and snappy here. There are no problems whatsoever. I can even insert a new row if I wanted to there. It's just super quick. You know, Excel, again, with Word open, there are no problems here. Let's open up PowerPoint then, next of all, and let's see how well PowerPoint works. And I'm quite sure it will work pretty fine. Now, let's have a look. Let's go to this Madison one here. And let's call this subtitle. What should we call it? Let's call it the iBoat again. And this iBoat presentation is going to be by no other than Tim Cook. So we can do that. And then what we can do is, let's say, let's put a picture in. I haven't done that yet. Everyone puts a picture in this. So let's get it from stock images here. And while that loads, let's have a look for a boat. Let's have a look at what my iBoat's going to look like. It's going to look like that there. So I'm going to insert that in. voila, a bit big, don't want it there, want it probably a bit more over here. And you can see here it's already starting to think themes and things. In fact, I really like that one. That looks pretty cool there. Got a bit of my boat there. And yeah, it looks absolutely fantastic. And we can even go into presentation mode. There we go. Looks absolutely fine. And yeah, it's really, really, really good. We've got all the different options at the top here. No problems at all. Everything's nice, it's super snappy and fast. There's not gonna be any problems there at all. Next all, we've got Outlook, and this is probably gonna be my Outlook with all my emails in it. So be warned, there's gonna be some strange emails coming up probably, but let's get that open there. And then let's just say, for example, I'm gonna go to my flagged emails, for example, and let's say I'm gonna do a new message, for example, so I can send out new messages if I wanted to. So that's no problems either. So next of all, let's move on to next. I'm just gonna minimize that one down. We're gonna go to Microsoft Edge. So in fact, actually, I'm gonna keep that open actually. Let's get Edge over the top of it there. So this is Microsoft Edge, is their own kind of browser out there. It's pretty good, to be honest. It's been optimized for the M1 processors out there, so the M1, M1 Pro, M1 Max. So it's not running on Rosetta 2, it fully works. But let's say, for example, I wanted to go to eBay, I can do that. Let's say I want to go to Apple. And let's have a look. Let's have a look. I know what we can look at. Let's have a look at some new MacBooks, because there are some new ones out, believe it or not, like this one here. So yeah, everything just seems to be working absolutely fine. And Edge here, nice and snappy. We've got that open. I want to open a few more tabs as well. I'm going to get that Microsoft Office, because that's what we're in. Let's open up LinkedIn. What's that? Is that Amazon Assistant or something? Amazon Assistant, yeah. And then let's have a look. Booking.com is always a good website as well. So yeah, this seems to be absolutely fine here. So that's really, really cool. Let's open up OneNote next of all. So I'm going to open this one up. So we've got a few tabs open there. We've got all these other apps open. And yeah, let's have a look. I've done here MacBook Pro test. Two, let's call it. Love Office on the M1 Pro and M1 Max. Let's say we want to insert a picture, for example. We can do that. I don't actually have any pictures because it's a new Mac, actually. I just thought of that. But you get the idea. I can draw a table in if I wanted to there and everything. That seems absolutely fine as well. And finally, what we have got is we've got OneDrive. It just opened up straight away on my Finder here. It's just a little shortcut. You could open it up just in the Finder. So if I just clicked on Finder there, I can go to OneDrive that way as well. So that looks absolutely cool. So you've got all these different apps open, like I said. And then finally, what you can also do is open up Apple's own version. So these ones here, this is the Office Suite with Office 365. So you do actually have to pay for them. If I flick around them, look, so we can flick and they load instantly. There's no problems whatsoever there. But what I will say is that you do have to pay for the Office Suite for a yearly rate or monthly rate, whatever it is. But you can actually get you the Apple version of Word, Excel and PowerPoint. And this is down here. You've got Pages to start with. And this is basically the equivalent of Word. And you can actually save things as a Word document as well. So if I click here on New Document, let's say this one here, a contemporary report, click Create on that one there. I can actually save it as a Word document. So if I export it to, there we go, Word. So it works no problems whatsoever. You can actually make it into a Word document. And then same with numbers as well. So numbers is basically the Excel equivalent. So let's say I want to make a new document there. I want to do this simple budget, for example. So again, we can do everything. We can change the colors. We can change the charts. All of the options are at the top here. A bit more differently how it's laid out to your traditional kind of office. But you can see I can change all my colors around if I wanted to do that. And there we go. I can have more options there. I'm going to go with a bit more darker and plainer. Actually, no, I like it bright. But you get the idea. There's that. And then finally, you've got Keynote. Now, I quickly will say as well, with Word, Numbers and Keynote, you can also insert PowerPoint files, PPTs, whatever they're called, Word documents, the doc files, and you can also insert the Excel file as well. There's no problem doing that. I'm going to click the turtle one here. So if you've got, for example, Office somewhere else and you've only got these three at home because they're free, you can just use them absolutely fine. Where's the turtle? There's no turtle. Well, that's a bit of a shame, but you get the idea. We can change it around. Let's call it turtle actually. And then we can actually save it as well. So we can save as, And just to show you guys here, you can go to Keynote, you can stick it wherever you want to stick it, and you can save it as its own kind of sort of document or anywhere you want to. But like I said, you can also export it to a PowerPoint file as well, and you can reopen it as a PowerPoint file, and it'll continue to keep saving that. So if I did open it and I kept clicking save, it won't save it as the kind of Keynote file, it'll save it, keep saving it as the actual PowerPoint file. So do remember that as well. So that is pretty cool. So yeah, there are a lot of options there, and like I said, I've got all of these things open here apart from OneDrive, because like I said, that's just a shortcut to the Finder. But there has been no problems with flicking around between all the different ways here, and Numbers, Key Pages, and that, the actual Office suite. It's absolutely fantastic. And remember, on Edge, for example, I've got all those tabs open. Everything is super snappy. You're not going to have any problems here whatsoever running Office, and also the Apple version of Office, on your M1 Pro or your M1 Max. Well then guys, there we go. You can see that Microsoft Office Suite for the Mac works perfectly fine on this MacBook Pro, along with those kind of Mac OS kind of equivalent kind of apps like Pages, Numbers, and Keynote as well. There's going to be no problems running it on this machine. So yeah, if you want to get one and you want to get Office, there's going to be no problems for you. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest news, reviews, and comparisons for Apple bits and pieces, please make sure you hit that subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I will see you really soon. Bye bye.